It's a two-hour delay Tuesday, ABE Stars. I'm Janice.
And I'm Emily. We are your amazing ABE TV anchors.
Today is Tuesday, January 16th, and it's a B2 day for special area classes.
Welcome back from your four-day weekend.
Friday's amazing birthday girls were Olivia Beck and Olivia Kearns. Miss D'Alessandro also got the gift of a day off for her birthday.
Over the weekend, the birthdays were Ahmad Allen,
Luna Rusk,
and Jay Dent.
Friday's half birthdays were Darren Hallfield
and Ben Schaefer.
The weekend's half birthdays were Cooper Gentry,
Elijah Hughes,
Lilia Gonzalez,
Addie Martin,
Dylan Powers,
and Isabella Figa.
Today's birthday stars are Ella English and Marvelous Mrs. Maskell, Ms. Macris.
The half birthday stars are Jared Asumang, Nathan Chris,
Tilly Dean,
Jackson Frisk,
and Olivia Isaac.
Have a great birthday, stars. After the pledge, go down to the office
and get a hug, high five, or pencil from Mr. Pennington.
Have a terrific birthday, stars. We were off school yesterday to celebrate another important birthday, Martin Luther King Jr.
We celebrate his life on the third Monday in January because his birthday's in January.
Oh, that makes sense.
Speaking of Martin Luther King, we have some facts about him. He skipped 9th and 12th grades and he went to college when he was only 15.
Did you know that there are over 1,000 streets named after him, and he was the first African American to be granted a holiday?
He was pretty amazing. Here's a quote from him. "Only in the darkness can you see the stars."
Dr. King was a civil rights leader. He lived through some very tough times, but he never gave up hope.
After the pledge, we'll hear more about him.
And sing happy birthday to Martin Luther King.
He was a great leader.
We can become better leaders by using the 7 habits.
Habit 2 is begin with the end in mind.
Okay, how would I begin with the end in mind?
Well, Emily, you could think about how if you finish your book, you can get closer and closer to honor reader.
So I should just read?
Well, beginning with the end in mind is all about planning. You need to know how you will make your goal of honor reader.
I get it. Know what you want, set a goal, and make a plan to get there.
I plan to have lunch pretty soon. What are we having?
We are having chicken Alfredo with a breadstick or a hot ham and cheese sandwich.
Our sides are golden corn and a spinach side salad.
We have a great joke for you from Zach and Mr. Brooks's class.
What do you call a cow slipping on ice?
I have no clue. A sliding cow?
No, a milkshake.
If you have a good joke, write it neatly and put your name on it.
Then turn it into the joke box outside of the ABTV studio.
Time for us to head out.
We have some first graders from Ms. D'Alessandro's class here to lead the pledge.
Over to you, stars.
Hi, my name's Chase.
Hi, my name's Gibson.
Hi, my name's Lily.
Hi, my name's Ryder.
Hi, my name's Destiny.
Please rise to the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hi, my name's Mrs. Laveras, and I wanted to share a story about my dad's experience with Dr. King. When we're talking about Martin Luther King Jr., I wonder if kids think, oh, that's ancient history. Because in many ways, it is. Dr. King was dead before I was born. So why do we read about, talk about, and study history? I think the most important thing about history is the story part. This is my story of the day my dad met Dr. King. When my dad was a young man, he was really bothered by the unfair rules, like that there were different water fountains and bathrooms and even schools for kids who had white skin and those who had brown skin. He was also really bothered that in many places, people who had brown skin weren't even allowed to vote to change those rules. But he knew that Dr. King and many other people were trying to change things. One thing that Dr. King was very good at was getting lawmakers to notice him. And he did this by bringing people together. He tried to show that lots of people thought the same way he did. So he organized marches. Thousands of people would come together and march to a location. And then lawmakers would see all these people gathered and think, huh, a lot of people must think the same way Dr. King thinks. Maybe we should listen. My mom and dad participated in one of those marches going from Selma, Alabama to Montgomery, Alabama. Hundreds of people came from all over. My parents came from California. The march took 4 days. It would be the same distance as if we chose to walk out of Amy Beverly and march all the way to Bloomington, where IU is. At the end of the march, something happened that forever changed my dad's life. He was standing right by Dr. King as Dr. King delivered a speech. A man from the FBI told my dad and five other guys standing by him that they thought that someone might try to kill Dr. King at the end of the speech. They asked my dad and the other men to form a human body shield around Dr. King and protect him with their bodies as he ran to the safety of a nearby church. All said yes. That day, my dad had the chance to give up his life for Dr. King. Luckily, there were no shots fired, but my dad was forever changed. One very real way that it changed him, and me too, is that after the march, my mom and dad wanted to show their love for all people, regardless of skin color. They decided to adopt my brother, who has brown skin, and my sister, who is even browner. Although my dad is almost 80, he continues to tell this story, and I do too. It's important that we don't forget. We can't forget that people of all skin colors work together to change unfair laws. We can't forget that we can change things by peacefully protesting. We can't forget that all people deserve the same chances in life. And we can't forget that we're not really there yet.